3, 2, 1.
Whoa! Oh my God!
No, this isn't the Hadron Super Collider. It's Anhad Sawney's slight variation. The Pina Collider. God. This senior at MIT was convinced the ingredients of a pina colada, pineapple and coconut, could be brought together in a more exciting way.
It made about half of the drink. Half of the drink got sprayed everywhere onto the walls, but we did come up with something at the end that was kind of edible.
Yeah!
Of course, that was all for fun. When this electrical engineering major from Lexington wants to get serious, he goes into combat mode. Anhad is captain of MIT's Combat Robotics Club.
Ares saw weakness in Warhard's eyes and struck with the fury of a thousand suns.
The team's headquarters, Area 51, a nondescript warehouse in Kendall Square, where they are constantly making their killer robot, Ares, more deadly.
That's what makes them cool. I mean, there's so much energy and there's so much power and physics that goes into everything.
Abby Dixon, a sophomore from Ipswich, enjoys seeing the theory she's learning in class put to such a thrilling real-world test.
Oh! And it's incredible to learn how we can use, you know, mechanical principles, material science, and control principles to kind of harness that power and put it exactly where we want it.
Oh, it's made its way up immediately into the jaws of Ares.
No.
Look at that tweak frame.
The frame is cracked in half.
The team's victories at the National Havoc Robot League in Connecticut have vaulted it to third best in the world after just 1 year together. Ares' secret weapon? A heavy chunk of spinning tool steel. Diabolical.
It spins 7,000 times every minute, so really, really fast. And then we kind of drive into the other robot and we smack them really, really hard with this piece of steel. And they go flying and parts break off and everything like that.
And it's incredible to hear everything and see everything, just this explosive energy happening right in front of you. And it's just so exciting and it makes me so proud to be a member of this team that can build a robot that can enact some pretty insane damage.
That sense of belonging can be a challenge at a place like MIT.
Getting an education at MIT, as the saying goes, is like getting a sip of water from a fire hose. It's intense. And those communities that students form tend to be tightly bonded, and they tend to keep those ties for the rest of their lives.
Dr. Jim Bales is the associate director at the Edgerton Center, named in honor of the legendary MIT professor Harold Edgerton.
This is the ethos of the Edgerton Center. People learn by trying and doing. And so our job is to give our students those opportunities.
In addition to providing tools and machine training for student projects, the Edgerton Center oversees clubs like the robotics team. Also sharing space in the Area 51 building, the First Nations launch team, where they live for the next launch.
Actually, I feel so sick on launch day normally. You're sitting there and they're counting down. You're like, please, please, please.
Peyton Meter from Maine is of Passamaquoddy heritage. She and seven other indigenous students from MIT traveled to Wisconsin recently to compete in the First Nations Launch High-Powered Rocket Competition.
Yeah, we are going to a launch pad. Oh,
Jeremy Minear is from the Pechanga tribe in California. This MIT junior tells us the team honors their heritage by smudging their rockets with smoldering herbs before sending them to the heavens.
Smudging goes to the sense of cultural cleansing. When it comes to the rocket, it's a form of blessing to try to give it the best chance of success as it goes upward. And if anything were to go wrong, it's in its best state.
So the First Nations launch competition that you referenced is sponsored by NASA.
By NASA, and they founded the program because they wanted to engage Native American students, and they want them to be more proficient and be exposed to STEM as well. So those are helpful to that community. By the way, the MIT team did, in fact, win the competition, the launch competition last September. They're very busy working on their next rocket for the coming year's competition.
All right.